What's going on, guys? So such a busy day today, I can't believe it. Like, there's so much stuff that I need to get done. I just needed to like step out and go for a little walk and then come back, be more productive after it. I know some of you guys might think like, what are you going for a walk for? You know, you've got so much stuff to do, you need to get to work, you need to start grinding, don't you? But actually, by going for a walk, I am so much more productive. When I come back, I can get so much more work done because I'm more relaxed. The exercise like gets more oxygen to my brain, gets the blood flow and stuff like that. And that's actually what I wanted to talk to you guys about, is productivity tips and hacks and stuff like that. Like, the most important thing that I've learned, like by researching stuff like this, is to stop multitasking, like stop doing multiple things at once, or stop trying to do multiple things at once, because in a way multitasking is impossible. Like, you can't do multiple things at once. It's too like, it's called the cognitive switching penalty or something like that. Like, when you try and do multiple things at once, your brain just can't like comprehend it, and it costs so much energy to like switch tasks that in the end you just feel absolutely fucked. Like, you're knackered, you're tired, but you haven't actually got a lot of work done. So what I do lately is, what I have been doing lately, is called mono idealism, where you focus on one task at a time and actually only focus on 3 tasks a day, and they're called like the most important tasks. So what you do is, on your to-do list, like underline 3 tasks that you want to get done that day, and then tackle them first and tackle them one at a time. And that is also my second tip for you guys today, is actually create a to-do list. And don't use an app, or you know, like what have we got nowadays, all these kinds of like productivity apps and all that. Nah, don't do that. Use pen and paper. Like, just go old school, old fashioned way, pen and paper, write down what you want to get done that day, and do it the night before as well. Like, so many times that I think, oh yeah, I'll write a to-do list today, but I'll do like after I wake up and go this way. And like, the first hour that I'm awake, all I do is just like scroll through my Instagram feed and stuff like that. I'm not actually productive. When I do it the night before, I get up of a morning and I know, oh yeah, got shit to do today. So then I actually get up and do it. So, to-do list, old-fashioned way, writing on pen and paper. And what you do is, when you create your to-do list, put like draw little boxes like left of your tasks, because like, when you tick off a box and you've done it, your brain releases dopamine because it knows that it's completed the task, and this will make it much easier to like finish tasks and do tasks like later on, because your brain knows that, okay, if I do this task, I'll tick off the box, I'll get dopamine. Speaking of dopamine, third tip is exercise. Like I'm doing now, exercise, walking, you know, even like fitness is just all, it's all about like getting the blood flowing, getting oxygen to the brain, wakes you up. It's like coffee in a way, it's like caffeine. But anyway, that is also why, like, I also think that fitness and business, they go hand in hand, you know what I mean? Like, there's so many things that, like, you just complement each other. Like, you see so many fitness YouTubers that are successful that they actually go and start their own business, or they do like some kind of business venture. And it's because fitness teaches you to, like, it's hard to explain. Fitness teaches you to be patient, but work hard and just aim for small. Hang on, change hand. Hands killing after that. Fitness teaches you to go for small amounts of progression each and every day, work hard, be patient, and it just teaches you like discipline and hard work. And that is why I think business and fitness are so similar, and they just complement each other. Anyway, last tip, because I'm just talking shit here, is hydrate. Drink water. I can understand it's so easy to just drink like excessive amounts of caffeine in the morning to wake yourself up, but actually what you need is water. You need to rehydrate yourself because you've been like drying out for like 8 hours on end because you've been asleep. So of a morning, what I try and do is get a litre of water in. Obviously with coffee, so I love coffee, like you will not take my morning coffee off me, but I also try and get a litre of water in so I'm rehydrated. Always got me caffeine for the extra boost and the taste, and I can just get so much more work done if I'm hydrated. Anyway, it's starting to rain, so I'm gonna head back. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you got something out of it, leave it a like, comment if you want to see more of these videos, subscribe to the channel for more, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.
Gotta do what I gotta do.